When using transparency for materials, we set the color's alpha value to specify an object's opacity. You might have a red material, and the alpha is used to make it semi-transparent. When used for texturing, we often think of the alpha as the amount of coverage. For example, to create a cutout leaf, you could specify for each texel whether the leaf is visible or not, an alpha of 1 or 0. However, you can get a better result by specifying an alpha between 1 and 0 for texels on the edge of a leaf. Each edge texel's alpha represents how much the leaf covers that particular texel. For example, this texel is covered by 6/10 of the leaf, so its alpha would be 0.6. What's interesting here is that a single alpha value is used for both opacity and coverage. It can even mean both at the same time. You could have a cutout figure whose texel has a 0.6 coverage and a 0.7 opacity to give a 0.42 alpha. Whatever the interpretation, we use the same overblending equation when putting one object atop another. Using alpha for coverage is a simplification. For example, when we have just an alpha value, we don't know the true area covered by an object. Combining a few coverages together is something of a best guess when we use blending. This is usually a fine assumption under normal circumstances, where only a few pixels have multiple overlapping edges.